So good morning, I'm going to be talking about the subcuticle suturing. So first you need to undermine the edges. So undermining is done to create a tissue plane so that you reduce the amount of tension while suturing. So you just lift up the tissue as such and you just pass your blade gently so that you create a plane. You don't have to overdo the undermining, you just want to do enough to get a tension-free closure. Here you can see that I'm creating a uniform plane throughout the wound edge. The next step is to anchor your suture material. So here I'm passing my needle entirely in the subcutaneous tissue. You need to hold the needle such that it faces towards you, and you're going to enter and exit both in the subcutaneous tissue. What this is going to do is it's going to anchor your suture material to the subcutaneous plane. So here you can see the needle has entered and exited both in the subcutaneous plane. So I'm just gonna secure this suture material with the surgeon's knot. So I'm gonna put two throws. And then one throw in the opposite direction. So now I'm going to cut the short end of the thread. So now my suture material is anchored to the subcutaneous tissue. So next I'm going to be taking the apical stitch. Now this stitch is going to be done with a reverse grip. And what we're doing here is we're going through the subcutaneous plane and we're going to come out at the dermis. See, it's going through the yellow subcutaneous tissue and it's coming out through the dermis. So let me show it to you again. It's going out through the subcutaneous tissue and coming out through the dermis. It helps to evert your tissue with the forceps so that you're in the right plane. So now we have secured the subcutaneous tissue to the dermis. So now we're ready for the serpentine suturing. So you begin at one edge, close to the apex, and you're going to rotate your needle driver such that it's entirely in the dermal tissue. You're going to rotate it horizontally as I'm showing here. You can use your forceps to evert the tissue and ensure that you get that horizontal throw. Now once you're out through one side, you want to enter parallelly through the opposite side. Here you're going to be using a reverse grip. It helps to angulate your needle slightly forward so that you can maneuver your hand through the tissue. So here you can see that it's going parallelly through the other edge. So once I pull the suture material, you can see how beautifully the edges approximate. So you're going to do the same thing on the entire length of the wound. So once you pull that, you're going to have a good approximation. So So the last step is to form a loop. So you're going to pass a bite to the opposite side, but don't pull it entirely out though, because you need to maintain the loop for the next step. So this is similar to the previous step where we're going parallelly in the dermal tissue, and I'm maintaining the loop. So the next step is to form the Aberdeen knot. So here you can see that I'm maintaining the loop, and with the help of my other fingers, I am pulling the needle end of the thread through. But you can notice that the needle end of the thread remains stationary, and I'm rotating my right hand outwards. Here I'm demonstrating it again. I'm holding the needle end stationary, and I'm pulling the loop through using my right hand and rotating it outwards. You can see in all these steps that the loop is still maintained and a knot is being formed and going into the suture. Here again, I'm holding the needle end straight, not moving it much, and I am pulling with my right hand outwards and I'm putting a knot. So there you have it, you have an Aberdeen knot. Now I'm still going to maintain this loop, because in the last step you're going to pass the needle end of the thread through. So here you can see I'm taking the needle end of the thread and I'm passing it through the loop of the Aberdeen knot. Here it has come out through the loop. Now you can let go of the loop and pull the needle end through and through. This completes your Aberdeen knot. And you can see the wound is approximated. Now I want to bury the suture because I'm using an absorbable suture material. So I'm just going to pass from the dermal tissue, I'm going to come out through the epidermis. Now I'm going to cut the suture material close.